Let's talk about the relationship between 16S sequence identity and taxonomy. To start, I'm going to consider the question of whether the standard threshold of 97% is optimal for creating OTUs. First, we need to define the problem. There are two main goals with OTU clustering. Bring different sequences from the same species together into a single cluster, and also bring bad sequences together with their correct sequences. Here, I'm going to assume that sequences are correct and focus on the problem of bringing sequences from a single species together. Errors can be handled in a separate processing step, for example, by denoising, and it's not reasonable to expect a single clustering algorithm to deal with the different types of errors, such as chimeras. So the input data is a set of correct biological sequences for many closely related species. We want a one-to-one correspondence between OTUs and species as far as possible. Since this is impossible to achieve in general, the best we can do is to achieve an even balance between lumping multiple species into one OTU and splitting a single species across different OTUs. To implement an experiment, I took 16S sequences from high-quality complete genomes in GenBank. These come from cultured strains, so they have authoritative species and genus names. Many different clustering methods are used to create OTUs, and many of them have been claimed to be better at this task. The single, average, and complete linkage, OptiClust, UPARS, UCLUST, Swarm, and so on. To test these methods, we need an accuracy measure which indicates how well the clusters are in one-to-one correspondence with species names. Splitting a species across two OTUs or lumping two species into the same OTU should be penalized by the metric. Many such metrics have been proposed, including normalized mutual information, the Matthews correlation coefficient, and so on. I tested many different clustering methods using several different accuracy metrics. Several published papers have claimed that one or another clustering method is better than others, but typically they use only their preferred accuracy metric, and the threshold is fixed at 97%. I found that if we choose an accuracy metric and then allow the threshold to vary, then all methods are equally good. The optimal threshold varies between methods, but usually not by very much. We can therefore talk about the best threshold without worrying too much about which clustering method and which accuracy metric was used. So here are the results. The 97% rule dates back to 1994. I found that it's clearly too low for species and it should be replaced. For full-length sequences, the optimal threshold for species is around 99%. For the popular V4 hypervariable region of 16S, the optimal threshold is 100%. In other words, denoised sequences are the best possible approximation to species without any further clustering. Now remember, this analysis was done with correct sequences. In practice, we are clustering noisy reads, and there the overall clustering pipeline does matter. To get good sequences and good OTUs, you should use UPARS or a denoiser. Note that even though 97% is too low for species, it's still the best threshold for UPARS if you want to avoid spurious low abundance OTUs. Just keep in mind that UPARS may tend to lump different species together into the same OTU. Now let's approach the relationship between taxonomy and identity from a different direction. Suppose we have two sequences A and B which have 95% identity. Do they belong to the same genus? If all we know is the identity, then we can't be sure. We can express the level of confidence as a probability that a pair of sequences belong to the same genus, given that they have 95% sequence identity. More generally, we can define the concept of a lowest common rank. If the LCR is genus, then the sequences belong to the same genus but different species. Similarly, if the LCR is family, then they belong to the same family but different genera. Note that the LCR is a rank, such as genus, not a particular group name, such as Salmonella. Suppose we have a set of 16S sequences with known taxonomy, and we select a pair at random. All we know is their sequence identity. Now we can calculate the probability that the LCR is, say, genus for all possible identities. This gives us a plot of the LCR probability as a function of identity, and of course we can do the same thing for other ranks. Here is the plot for full-length 16S sequences. Notice that at 97% identity, the probability that the sequences belong to the same species is very low, as indicated by the dotted red line. This is consistent with the early result that the optimal clustering threshold for species is around 99%. The threshold of 95% is often considered to be an approximation for genus, but as you can see, from 95% to 97% identity, the sequences are most likely to belong to different genera in the same family. In the range of 91 to 93%, the lowest common rank is ambiguous and could be family, order, or class. Here is the plot for the V4 hypervariable region, which is around 250 nucleotides long compared to 1500 nucleotides for the full-length gene. Even at 99% identity, the probability that the sequence belongs to the same species is very low, confirming that 100% is a better species clustering threshold for V4. At 97 to 98%, the sequences most likely belong to different genera in the same family, which shows that the standard 97% threshold may have a strong tendency to lump different genera together into the same OTU, as well as different species. At 93 to 95% identity, the lowest common rank could be family, order, or class.